帅，韩国的追星，哎，你看不是也不是吧？Will you please give it up for William, please? Thank you.
Thank you for coming here. Sorry for the technical problems that we faced just now. We tried to change it to the TV, but it didn't quite work. So we are back to the big screen. The resolution is not as good, so there might be things that you cannot see. The first time I went to Brunei was 2 years back.Probably around 2 years back. I've always gotten invitations from the Brunei people asking me to go. But from what I know of Brunei diving, from what I've heard, from what I've seen of other people's photos, it's green water. So I was never interested until I was told about a special nudibranch. You cannot really see it from this picture on the screen here, but it's here, this lump of black thing here. It's a nudibranch that feeds on the goby's fin.The mucus of the goby's fin. Okay, I have been looking for this nudibranch for a long time, and they told me in Brunei you can find it. So that actually brought me to Brunei. In the next picture, I hope you can see it better. You can see the nudibranch with the mouth on the fin, and it's trying to eat the mucus of the goby. So this is what I went there for. But the thing is, I got totally blown away by what I saw.Of the reef in Brunei, and within a few months, I was back there again doing other shoots. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is to quickly show you what I've seen in Brunei within my very short few trips. The goby that we shot with the nudibranch was taken in Pelong Rocks. Okay, that's a collection of few rocks out in the sea in the bay.There are sandy areas at the bottom. You see a lot of gobies there. So these are the gobies that we can find there. In Brunei, waters, because there are not a lot of divers, and so far I think most of the dive shops are very conscious about marine conservation. So interaction with the animals is actually kept very strict. So the animals are not afraid of people. And you can get quite close to the animal there, and the animal actually stays.For you to take photos. So you will see a lot of very close-up shots of animals, and you will see behaviors that you normally don't see because the animals are very comfortable with you around. So this was another shrimp goby. It was finning its burrow, and while it was doing that, it was trying to spit out the sand that it collected from inside the place it stays. So when it was spitting out the sand, one of the seashells was stuck in the lip.It couldn't get the seashell out, nor could it get it in. So it was stuck there for a few seconds, and it was trying very hard to spit it out. So I was able to get very close to the shirt because it was totally distracted. You can see the seashell on inside the mouth. And it took it about 10 seconds or 15 seconds before the seashell was cut a bit off. And between that period, I got a lot of pictures of it doing that.This is a bit dark here on the screen, but it's a complete goby, the red color version, which is very beautiful. This is a blenny, alright. This one was very tiny. The head itself is probably about 3 mm large. Now, the first trip when I went to Brunei, I took shots of tunicates. I love taking shots of tunicates, and when I was taking the photos, I did not know what I was taking. I was taking shots of tunicates.When I came back and I looked at the picture in the computer, I looked at the tunicate that I shot, and I was very surprised that, you know, it actually turned out to look like a cat, a cheetah. Alright, so I talked to the operators and we went back to the same place, and we looked at every single tunicate that was like that. You can actually see them in different stages of contracting. Some of them looks like a cat, some of them looks like a Batman, some of them looks like a skull.Imagination is good enough, you know, you can find anything you want them to be, and it's actually quite interesting there. Alright, actually after I shot this photo, a few photography friends, okay, one from Indonesia, Pak Hendra, who is very famous, and another friend of mine who is a marine biologist. They got really interested in this and they followed me to Brunei just to shoot this. By the way, Dr. Seifert, a famous photographer from Vancouver, he saw this picture and he kept asking me to bring him back, to bring him to Brunei someday. He wanted to shoot this as well. This is a drawing string on inside a soft collar.
This is a song that's very personal to me. It's a love song. Like most of my songs, very intimate and really about just saying to somebody, you know, you're everything to me, and I just wanted to tell you that. It's called The Love I've Found.
All right, this I used oil rig that is broken up into about 7 parts that is sunk into the seabed. And over the years, it's collected a lot of soft corals and all this growing on it, and then you have a big school of barracuda living there. When I first started diving there, the school of barracuda wasn't big enough, but you can get very close to them. Recently, when I was there, the barracuda school is huge. Alright, so this was shot quite early when the barracuda school wasn't that big, but they were actually very easy to shoot. Same rig brief. We had a cuttlefish that was very friendly, I could get very close to. And this is how reef look like. I wish you can see the actual colors and all this, but this screen actually doesn't show it. Okay, so I'm sorry about that. And in the dark shadow parts, there are actually details, and the screen doesn't really show anything. But you probably have to go to Brunei yourself to find out how it looks like. Alright, one of the dives when I was diving at Rig Reef, we saw a pair of copper pen butterfly fish. You know, these butterfly fish are usually very hard to get close to, but I was able to spend a whole dive there with them. This was shot with a fish eye lens, so you can imagine how close I must be with the butterfly fish. They were busy feeding and they couldn't care less about your camera, so your camera was almost touching them, and they were just happily feeding away. This is a picture of a trumpet fish that I shot in Brunei. Same thing, I wish the resolution was any better than this so that you could see the details. You can get very close to the fishes there in Brunei. This was shot on the fisheye lens. I sometimes spend time with fishes that you can get close to so you can probably get good pictures. In Brunei, this is quite often the case that you can get very close to the fishes. When I was spending time with this, I got my shot, I left, and I have a friend who was with me. He was using a point and shoot, he was testing a point and shoot camera at that time, and he followed the fish longer. So he spent about half an hour with the fish, and he got this shot. All right, this is actually from the gentleman over there, Mr. Dex. Okay. He found the fish very friendly and he thought that, you know, it might be possible for him to get something from the same fish, and he spent time and he was rewarded with a nice shot like this. This is a shot from a G12 camera that was tested by Dex also. Okay, this is a cement wreck. I went to Seaman Drag many times, I dived there many times, but most of the time I was actually there shooting planktons, alright, which you will see the pictures later. So the camera was set up for very small things and then I couldn't get the wide angle pictures. The few times I went there with a wide angle camera, I was so happily enjoying myself with the dive there. Seaman Drag is actually very, very interesting to dive. So, you know, sometimes I get too happily enjoying myself there diving, I forgot to shoot. Okay. The one time that I tried to shoot when I was there, I was working on a lionfish. I usually set the camera to a certain point that you go for broke. Either you get a very good picture or you get no picture at all. That day I wasn't lucky, so I didn't get any shot. But I have plans to go back there again and try to get the shot I want. The four big wrecks, alright, the Seaman, the US wreck, the Australian wreck, and the Blue Water wreck, okay, those are technically not in Brunei waters, those are in Labuan waters. In Brunei waters, there's a wreck that I really love, it's called Cunningham wreck. It's a very small wreck, okay, I mean from the front, it doesn't look very interesting. But when you swim towards the wreck, actually you don't see the wreck. It's covered by fish. Only when you penetrated the school of fish, then you can see the wreck below. When you go under the wreck, there's a big school of strippers there. And when the when there are big fishes swimming around, the sweepers will dart around in desperate moves to run away from the predator. So actually the movement is very interesting. So if you spend time there, you are going to see a lot of action. Around Cunningham Wreck, you will see a lot of cardinal fish, and most of the time you will find them mating. Alright, this is a mating pair of cardinal fish. This is a picture of Dex 2. Okay, he shot this in one of the reefs there. You can see the water is not as bad as you think, alright? And the fish life is actually very good in Brunei. Now in Brunei waters, the government actually did a lot in protecting so that illegal fishing is not done there. So they have probably the biggest fish count in this region. And the biodiversity is actually quite amazing. This is a pair of unidentified nudibranch that the gentleman over here, Paul, has found for me when I was diving there. We went down and it took us some time, because the nudibranch are really, really, really tiny. It took us some time to locate them, but once you find them, I mean, they're really beautiful to look at. The other nudibranch on the other side look as if it's quite bare on the top. Apparently, they have the ability to shed all those little things that's growing on the back, and then they will grow it back later. Now, this is what Brunei is best known for, Bonellas. This is a big nudibranch, and very beautiful to look at. They are usually quite deep, so it would be good if you are nitrox trained and you go down with a nitrox tank. Alright, we spend a lot of time shooting this animal. They feed on hydrox, and if they are not happy with the substrate they are on, they usually come out for a swim to find better places to feed on. This is the other type of bonella. As you can tell, there is a string in front. So sometimes you have conventional string on them running about. This one wasn't happy with the bottom, sea bottom that it was on. It ran out of food, so it was up swimming. So these are a collection of nudibranchs that we can find in Brunei water. Okay, plankton. I spent a lot of time in Brunei shooting plankton. I have a love of planktons. All right, they are very difficult to shoot, but it's challenging when you can get the bottles. Stephen, who is the owner of the operation that I dive with, he came with me on one dive. And we shot some jellyfish for that dive. He was seasick for the next 3 days. Okay, so plankton shooting is challenging, but when you can get the shot, it's actually very interesting. The animal below is called a sea butterfly. You cannot see the details, the minute membrane that is on it. It's actually a very beautiful animal that swims like Dumbo the elephant. Alright, the one on top, I do not know what it is. The sea butterfly is almost guaranteed. Anytime you go, you will find. This is probably a planktonic stage of a shrimp, a lobster or something like this. This is a jellyfish that got our dear Stephen seasick for 3 days. Okay, during one of the dives when I was doing in Brunei, when we were surfacing, coming up from the dive, I saw this jellyfish that was in mid-water. This is not shot with filters and everything, alright? The jellyfish is this color. It was neon green in color. Of course, I found it, so it's mine to shoot, alright? There are other photographers crowding beside me, and they wanted to have a shot of this. I said, no, this is mine. You know, you wait for your turn. So I spent a lot of time with it, and after I got the shot I want, I looked around, thinking that, okay, they can come and shoot the animal now. I looked around, there were hundreds of these around me. So actually, if you talk to the operator, at certain time of the year, you will see a lot of these around. After I left, of course, they were gone for a period of time. then they came back many times also. So the operator might know on which months they will appear. So if you're interested in shooting something like this, you can talk to them. Now, recently, this picture was used for a Chinese issue of National Geo magazine. And the people who used that told me, you see this lump in the center? It's actually a parasite clam that lives within the jellyfish. The jellyfish is actually small. So can you imagine how small the clam is? All right, so that's what they told me. So inside the lump is actually a clam. We found a pelagic tunicate that is a plankton as well that swims in the water of the wreck, which is why I was there every day with a macro camera set up trying to shoot this tunicate and not getting any pictures of the getting wide angle pictures of the wreck. Now you cannot see from here because the details is not there. It actually has a tail that swims, alright? The front is it looks like a head of the Hindu monkey god. Alright, but at the back there's a tail that swims. It was very interesting to look at in the water, but sorry, the resolution here isn't enough to show. Resolution isn't enough to show it here too. So this is a snail, planktonic snail with you can see only two tentacles here. There are actually two more out there, not on this screen, sorry, but if you touch the snail, the tentacles will all retract into the shell. Alright, if you give it some time, you will see the tentacles coming back out again. This is probably a better photo that you can see from on this screen. You can see there are total four tentacles. And then the eye is over there. I was told actually this snail will live its whole life in the planktonic stage and it will not grow into a full snail. Okay, the shell itself maybe 2 mm. All right, that's how small it is. Recently, I was in Shanghai and I had I spoke to Yoshi, who is a photographer, famous photographer based in Cebu, and he showed me some pictures that he shot of this too. So apparently, you can find them in many places, but in Brunei waters, they are all over the place. Alright, this is a pelagic tunicate with a fish living inside for protection. Now, several years ago, 2 Christmases ago, I sent this out as a Christmas card to all my friends on internet email. And one of these people that I sent to was Ned and Anna Deloach, very famous photographer from the States in Florida. They forwarded it to another photographer friend of theirs, who is Norbert Wu. Norbert Wu is one of the lead photographers of National Geo, alright? And Norbert Wu is famous for planktons. When I was studying in university, I grew up with Norbert Wu's pictures of planktons. And Norbert wrote to me, after he saw the picture, he said he couldn't open the file. But he was interested in seeing the picture because he heard that the picture is good from Ned and Anna. So I wrote to him telling him that I'm one of his biggest fans, all right? I feel bad about showing him my picture. But he wrote back, he insisted he wanted to see the picture. So I sent the picture to him, and then he wrote back after receiving the file. He said he is now a fan of a fan, all right? So with that, I'm going to end today's talk. What I'm going to tell you now is, you know, Brunei is basically a new destination. Not a lot of people know about the diving there. There are a lot of possibilities, okay, with new animals that has not yet been discovered, with animals that are in other places but it's easier to approach. And if you are good with finding animals, or actually the dive guide would help you, you will find Brunei an interesting place to dive. Thank you very much.